I do apologize for crying. I haven't read this book since I was a child, and I didn't remember how much it made me sad. But it's such a great story. She was quite the loveliest fairy in the whole world. Her dress was a pearl of dewdrops, and there were flowers round her neck, and in her hair and her face was the most perfect flower of all. And she came close to the little rabbit and gathered him up in her arms and kissed him on the velvet nose. Mateen nose that was all damp from crying. "Little rabbit," she said, "don't you know who I am?" The rabbit looked up at her, and it seemed to him that he had seen her face before, but he couldn't think where. "I am the nursery magic fairy," she said. "I take care of all the playthings children have loved when they are old and worn out, and the children don't need them anymore. Then I come and take them away with me and turn them into real." "Wasn't I real before?" asked the little rabbit. "You were real to the boy," said the fairy. "Because he loved you. Now you shall be real to everyone." And she held the little rabbit close to her arms and flew with him into the wood. It was light now, for the moon had risen. All the forest was beautiful, and the fronds and the bracken shone like frosted silver. It was open glade between tree trunks. The wild rabbits danced with their shadows on the velvet grass, but when they saw the fairy, they all stopped dancing and stood round in a ring to stare at her. "I brought you a new playfellow," the fairy said. "You must be very kind to him. All he needs to know is in Rabbit Land, for he is going to live with you forever and ever." And she kissed the little rabbit again and put him down on the grass. "Run and play, little rabbit," she said. But the little rabbit sat quite still for a moment and never moved. For when he saw the wild rabbits dancing around him, she suddenly remembered about his hind legs, and she didn't want them to see that he was once made all in one piece. He didn't know that when the fairy kissed him again, the last time she had changed him into him altogether, and now he might have sat there a long time too shy to move. If just then something hadn't tickled his nose, and before he thought that he was going to be lifted his hind toe to scratch, and he found that he actually had hind legs instead of dingy velvet. He had brown fur, soft and shiny, his ears twitching by themselves, and his whiskers were so long that they brushed the grass. He gave a one leap, and the joy of using those hind legs was so great that he went springing about turf on them, jumping sideways and whirling round as the others did, and he grew so excited that when he last did stop to look for the fairy, she had gone. He was a real rabbit at last, at home with the other rabbits. Autumn passed and winter, and in the spring, when the days grew warm and sunny, the boy went out to play in the wood behind the house. And while he was playing, two rabbits crept out from the bracken and peeped at him. One of them was brown all over, but the other had strange markings under his fur, and though long ago he had been spotted, the spots still showed through. And about his little soft nose and his round black eyes, there was something familiar. So the boy had thought to himself, "Why, he looks like my old bunny that was lost when I had scarlet fever." But he never knew that it was really his own bunny, come back to look at the child who first helped him to be real. Okay, so that was me reading the Velveteen Rabbit. I apologize for crying. This book made me sad. I haven't read it since I was a child, but thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I post every day except for Tuesday and Friday afternoon sometimes. And I'll see you in another video soon. Bye!